John Rogers makes his fame during the 1860s as a sculptor of Civil War subjects. And he bursts onto the scene in New York with this small sculpture called The Slave Auction from actually 1859. And what we see here is a slave family about to be divided at auction. On the left is the father, who looks defiant with his arms folded. On the right is the mother, who's desperately clinging to her child. And you can see that she has Caucasian features. And Rogers makes no bones about showing us the sexual abuse that sometimes slave masters are perpetrating on their slaves. If you look carefully at the auctioneer, you see these two little curls of hair that almost look like devil's horns. And again, this is a very pointed reference. And Rogers comes to New York from New England as a fervent abolitionist. And he's coming from a hotbed of anti-slavery sentiment. He comes to New York thinking that he will have no trouble selling this sculpture, the slave auction. What he finds, though, is something quite different. He writes home to his family in 1859 that he can't get any stores in New York to place his sculpture to sell because they're afraid of offending their Southern customers.
Actually, this is a wonderful place to start the exhibition. It's also at the very start of a book that I just had the privilege of preparing for the Historical Society that will be published next spring, called The History of the Civil War in 50 Objects from the New York Historical Society. And this is one of the earliest pieces. As you point out, Rogers had no end of trouble selling it in New York. He did something actually in terms of marketing that was new. When he realized that he was having trouble getting this into the windows of shops on Broadway, where Southern women might be horrified by its appearance, he actually began pushcart sales. And supposedly, Henry Ward Beecher found it on one of these pushcarts. He hired African Americans to wheel it around, and Beecher, whom he later sculpted, saw the piece and bought one, later became a subject. What I think is crucially important about this is to remember the year. It comes out in the end in the year of John Brown's raid. John Brown is executed as well in 1859. So it's a momentous period of frayed nerves and high anxiety in the country. This piece reflects that anxiety in a major way. Another thing that I think pegs it to an actual event is there had been a huge, gruesome mass slave auction near Savannah, Georgia. I think he got the idea for this from the New York Tribune's extensive coverage of that mass slave auction. 400 human beings sold, along with cattle, which is exactly what it says on the auctioneer's
podium.
Right
there on the podium.
So it was a gruesome story. The Tribune played it in a big way for its anti-slavery audience, and I think this is, in a way, an artistic reaction. And the great feature is the children. We don't know where they're going to be destined. They may not even stay with the mother.
Exactly.
It may be
exactly.
Total separation. It's very powerful.
And they're a bit hidden from our view, just like their future. We don't know what will happen.